What's up, bitches?
On my last trip, I didn't do a captain's log, and it made it significantly less fun for me to edit. And when I have a captain's log, I crack myself up because I think I'm pretty funny. So, we're doing it. I'm coming to you live, except not live, because I'm gonna edit this before I post it. From Times Square. This is a great shot. Wow. It's like 5 a.m. We're gonna watch the sunrise. Would be romantic if this weren't such a loud and smelly city. I guess, I mean, if you're into that, it's still romantic. We took a bus here overnight, and now we're here. Drinking coffee because it's cold as shit. My hair has already gotten fucked up, even though I specifically did it so it would look nice in photos today, but that's fine. Everything's fine. No matter what you see, I'm so happy to be here. We're now in Central Park where I just did my makeup and got changed. So now I look less like a corpse, which is exciting. Ducking into random shops and looking at random shit and pretending like we're rich enough to buy any of it, which we are not. I've died and gone to heaven. All the trauma in my life has been worth it, just for this moment. In my vlog. So what have we done today? We ducked into a bunch of art galleries, that was cool. We went and got our oars photographed, also cool. We killed some men, smoked crack, the usual. Our legs really hurt because we have walked 17 kilometers so far. So we're heading to the Brooklyn Bridge and then we're gonna get on a ferry and go back to Midtown and then check into our hostel that we still have not checked into. We've just been wandering around all day with our shit for the weekend on our backs. We're very strong but also weak and in pain. We're on a bridge. How's it feel, Charlie?
So good. Sloan and Charles on the Brooklyn Bridge. Woo!
Charles didn't write this, but he may as well have.
We're here in the Big Apple having a good time.
Where are the medium-sized apples at?
Right.
We don't know. These are the real questions. Like with Twin Peaks, don't trust the owls. Do you usually trust owls? The owls are not what they seem. What do they usually seem? People don't ask these things. Anyway, I've got blisters on my feet and I'm pretty sure they're like bursting now, which is really uncomfortable.
Why are you sharing this with the internet? I'm gonna edit all of that out. It is 6 p.m. and we just checked out of the hostel and we've just been doing shit all day, like carrying all our stuff with us, amassing more stuff. Oh man. We finished our day off at Holographic Studios, which was fucking amazing. The guy who makes all the holographic art was just super chill and like so friendly and nice. And because I was being a complete nerd because I love rainbow things, he just gave me free shit. Hell yeah, like 10 out of 10.
I think part of why the Holographic Studios guy was so nice to me is because I rolled into his store with this keychain, just not holographic, but iridescent.
My holographic toiletries bag. My holographic like wristlet on my camera.
And then my phone case. I'm filming this video on my phone, so I mean, you can't really see my phone case, but it's a wallet phone case, so part of it folds, but it's also iridescent. So clearly I'm committed to the vibe. This place was so on brand for me.
Actually, come to think of it, doing aura photos and getting a bunch of holographic shit is just very on brand for me. So on brand. Usually when I travel, I don't do this much shit in one day because it's very overwhelming and exhausting. That was such a good day. I feel alive. I feel alive. My calves hurt, but I could keep going. Except not. It's 100% nap time right now. Charles has just horrific blisters right now, and my calves are like seizing up because we have walked 23 kilometers today. So that's no bueno, but I'm just so happy. It's been a great day for me. I mean, I don't have horrific blisters on my foot, so that helps. I'm just in such a good mood. So as a well-known expert of New York City, I've been giving Charles a very in-depth tour of everything I know about the city. So grass and also rocks are indigenous to New York City. All the grass you see outside of New York isn't real grass. Rocks, they're real. They're indigenous to everywhere, but especially New York City. And Charles asked what especially meant in that context, and I don't understand the question, so. I was also saying that in the sewers of New York, there are many turtles that only progressed to adolescent age, and then they stop there. And they're very advanced in Asiatic martial arts. Misconception that they're all ninjas. That's not necessarily true. If you've ever seen that video of the pizza rat in the New York City subway, he swam directly out of the sewers where he was probably busy taking care of turtles because that's the symbiotic relationship that exists in New York City sewers. And they love pizza. So the rats will often collect pizza for their turtle dependents. Dude, take care of them. I'm pretty much just wandering around the woods, shit posting and giggling to myself, and Charles is just my babysitter. He's 6 months younger than I am. In true Vancouverite fashion, I just said, without really thinking about it, you know what, this park is actually pretty good. I'm park sushi. You know how many parks I've fucking been in? How many parks the last one? This one's pretty good. I give it a solid 3 out of 5 stars on Yelp. Typical me fashion. I guess everything I do is in typical me fashion because I'm the one doing it. I bought a bunch of candies that don't exist in Canada. Part two. We have Sour Jacks. Please ignore the fact that I ripped off some of my nail polish out of sheer boredom while waiting in line at Milk today. We have Baby Ruth, Sour Jacks, Milky Way, Mamba, and Mounds. I already ate a Mamba, so this isn't a first impressions review. It's basically a Starburst. I said it's a confused Starburst, but like, sign me up, I don't give a shit. I'm wondering why Mounds is named so breastily.
Wow.
But like, you know, why? And there's two of them. Like, was that intentional? I need to know. Did someone do this on purpose? Also, I'm dressed like a fisherman, and I'm not sorry. I hope that my eyes are like bright red this whole video. I was born to shitpost. So it says it's dark chocolate and coconut. Oh. I'll just put that back in its pocket for the time being.
Is it not good?
So I have other things to try in this first impressions video. We're not doing swatches because that didn't work out so well last time. And it turned out in the end that I wasn't even reviewing makeup. So it's just a baffling day. What should I do next?
You can now vote online as to what Sarah should eat next.
Nobody can vote. Can you imagine? I know how to time travel and I'm using my skill not to like benefit the world or even really myself. I'm doing it just so other people can make my decisions as they're happening.
Excuse me, pupper. Could you be quiet? We're trying to shitpost right now.
It's very important that you be quiet while we shitpost. Let's do Sour Jacks. All right, I'm getting some tension while opening this. Not a fan. What is this shape supposed to be? Is that supposed to be a bear? Is it a coffin? Because if so, that's fucking lit. Remind children of their mortality as they eat your candy. It's like a Sour Patch Kid. Is that the same thing? Oh my god, it totally is. Look at this fuck. Okay, so I cheated. I guess this does exist in Canada, just under a different brand name. I'm not an authentic candy blocker.
Your audience is gonna be outraged.
My audience of two people. This is the content that the people are hungry for.
Oh.
Okay, so I mean, I cheated, and I'm not sorry because I'm still gonna eat it. This is a Milky Way. It's by Mars Bar, which apparently doesn't exist in America, so we have something over you, the US of A. Aside from, can I make political jokes? Is that too niche for my chocolate fans?
Yeah, you might really divide the two people who are watching this.
Truly. Canada has many things over the US.
And Degrassi, so.
Yeah. All you need in a country. All right. Oh, that was good. It tastes like a Mars Bar. And it's by the Mars Company. So is this just America's answer to a Mars bar? Wait, taste this. Is this a Mars bar? Do you know what a Mars bar tastes like off the top of your head?
Yeah, I do.
I have the flavor memorized.
I'm a Mars bar expert.
Are you?
No. Yeah, that's a Mars bar.
What the fuck? Well, I've been lied to multiple times. Well, I didn't mean to cheat so aggressively. Let's hope that Baby Ruth are actually something unique. I think this got like packaged weirdly because like you'd think that this label would be entirely on the front part of the chocolate bar, but it's not. So points off for that. Nestle. Oh, I gave my money to Nestle. They're bad. Mm-hmm. It's okay. Ethical capitalism is impossible.
So why bother trying, right?
Yeah, fuck it. I own a Gucci belt. I don't give a fuck. We may as well just light the whole world on fire. Then it would just be a dumpster fire. How much do you want to bet this is just an O. Henry? Is O. Henry a thing you can buy here? This totally fucking is an O. Henry. This is why Canada and US relations are the worst right now that they've been in like several decades. It's this dishonesty. At least two of these things don't exist in Canada. One of them, I'm gonna rate 3 out of 5 boobs. Unless I'm gonna rate 1 confused starburst. What should I rate the other ones?
They're all lies. Just rate them as lies.
I rate these, I'm trying to think of like mediocre Canadian things. I rate this a Justin Trudeau because it says it's one thing and it turns out to be something entirely different. I really don't know what to rate these. I've had them before. They taste delicious. It wasn't really what I was expecting. I mean, that applies to all of them. What are other mediocre Canadian things?
Beaver.
Have you ever seen beaver teeth? Fun fact about beaver teeth. The reason why they're so orange is because they have so much iron coating them, so they're hella strong. That's one of the last parts of a beaver skeleton to decompose. Why do I know these things? Well, I mean, I entertained myself on this chocolate review. I'm gonna binge eat all of this and probably vomit now. Do you have any closing remarks, Charles?
It's been a lot of fun to be a part of this process.
Has it?
You're really gonna put my name out there.
I should just edit you out of the whole thing.
You're really elevating my name. I really appreciate that.
I've now been laughed at by passerby. We're done here.